I'm Caitlin. I'm the nature interpreter at the Gorge Waterway Nature House, and today I'm going to be telling you about chitons.
Chitons have a shell made up of 8 separate plates. These plates are articulated together, which makes the shell flexible. This allows chitons to bend their bodies to move over uneven rocks. They can also curl up into a ball if they are removed from a rock to protect their softer underside from predators. The 8 plates are surrounded by the mantle, which you can see around the edges of the chiton. On this mossy chiton, the mantle is covered in small bristles, but the color and texture vary between species. Underneath the mantle, chitons have a muscular foot, which they use to hold tightly onto rocks. They also have gills, which are between the mantle and the foot on either side of the body. Chitons have a head at the front of their body, and they eat using a radula, which is a tongue-like structure with rows of teeth that acts sort of like sandpaper. In this video clip, you can see a chiton eating using its radula. Most species of chitons, like this one, use their radula to scrape algae off of rocks. However, there are some species that are carnivorous, like the red-veiled chiton, which has a sort of hood or veil at the front of its mantle that it can clamp down over prey before eating it with its radula. In the Seaquaria, we have 2 different species of chitons. The black Katy chiton has white plates surrounded by a black leathery mantle. We also have a mossy chiton, which is dark brown and has bristles on the edges of its mantle. There are also many other species of chitons that live in the Salish Sea, including the gumboot chiton, which is the largest species of chiton in the world. Chitons generally live in the intertidal zone. They are sensitive to direct sunlight, so they hide in sheltered areas during the day and only move around to feed at night. The best place to find chitons is under rocks in sheltered areas of the beach. However, both the black Katy chiton and the mossy chiton are less sensitive to sunlight than other species, so you might sometimes see them on top of rocks as well. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I'll be back next week to talk about hermit crabs. Thanks for watching!